17, you read this, and it is he who will go as a forerunner before him in the spirit and power of Elijah to turn the hearts of the fathers. So the comparison there is not about the physical, but about the spiritual and the message and the prophecy that was coming both with Elijah and with John the Baptist. Now, here's the clincher that it's not reincarnation. What do you know about Elijah?
Yeah, he was, let's see.
Did he die?
No, he didn't.
Exactly. So there is no reincarnation. Reincarnation means re-enfleshed, or the flesh is not gone.
Right.
So there's no way to have reincarnation. Plus, Scripture has, over and over again, it makes claims that there isn't any reincarnation. It says it's appointed for man to die once, and then the judgment in Hebrews. And then in Philippians, Paul says the absence from the body is to be present with the Lord. So there's no place for it.
In the Old Testament, that would have been, I'm just sure there would have been more examples of that, and it really, there's not. And I knew just deep down that the whole, I mean, I didn't want it to be, or, you know, I was hoping, because I already think I really knew that it was the Spirit.
That's exactly the way you should study Scripture. You should ask those questions. Not about, you know, like you said, not hoping for an outcome or trying to squeeze an outcome in there. You're just letting it breathe and in that case, it's very easy to look at that and think that it is at least leaning towards reincarnation. But once you start letting it, you know, unfold a little bit and explain itself, you start to see that there's no real room for reincarnation there. At all, Michael. But a great question. I love the fact that you're thinking through those things and processing, because a lot of people just kind of stare at Scripture, and when you're actually studying it and wanting to poke at it and look and see what it has to say, I think it's very powerful.
Ever sorry. Efficient and powerful.
Step into the 2011 Acura RDX. The 2011 RDX delivers luxury and performance with a turbocharged engine and the available super-handling all-wheel drive that enhances cornering and maneuverability.
Under the hood, you'll find a four-cylinder engine with more than 200 horsepower, providing a smooth and predictable driving experience. Acura perfected each and every component on the exterior surface. An integrated spoiler at the rear contributes to a sporty look, enhancing the aggressive stance.
The interior of this vehicle is nothing short of spectacular, treating occupant comfort with paramount concern. Acura prioritized comfort and style by including rear view camera, xenon high intensity discharge headlights, Bluetooth enabled, and the power moonroof opens up the cabin to the natural environment. The RDX key remote automatically activates your personalized seating and mirror settings when you open the driver's door.
Acura ensures the safety and security of its passengers with equipment such as dual front impact airbags, head curtain airbags, and four-wheel disc brakes with ABS. You'll see better when backing up, thanks to Rear Park Assist, which watches out for obstacles behind your vehicle.
The 2011 Acura RDX. Distinctly rendered with the utmost precision, this vehicle is constructed with a discerning driver in mind.
Yeah, this TV. Under the gas. Sorry. Gas, hey. Undivided. Inside. Stephen. Yes, man.
My boss, yours is red. It's the first sign. This is me. Chris.
Come I'm gonna give you what I'm giving.
Sorry, sir. Sorry for. Jeff Keisha Robert. We should have so much. Can you buy? Give us all you want to say.